It is the high fashion symbol of one of the lowest points the nation has ever endured. That pink Chanel suit Jacqueline Kennedy was wearing when her husband was shot 50 years ago this Friday. Here she was, that iconic outfit, to this day has not been washed. Did you know that? It is a deliberate and distinct decision Mrs. Kennedy made in the hours following her husband's death, according to the New York Times. Let me quote this fascinating article for you from the Times. They wrote this: on the plane back to Washington, in her pink Chanel suit caked with her husband's blood, Jackie Kennedy resisted all suggestions from her aides that she clean herself up. Instead, she said, let them see what they've done. The New York Times goes on to report that suit, that pink suit, is now in a vault, preserved by the National Archives. Caroline Kennedy has instructed that pink outfit not be seen by the public until the year 2103. I want to turn now to the author of the book, Jackie Style. Pam Keogh joins me now, live from New York. And Pam, I mean, you have written so much. When we talk about this Chanel suit, before we even talk about the tragic moment, the color of the suit, it's a strong color. What do you think the First Lady was going for there?
Well, she knew what she was doing. It was a very striking pink, and she knew she'd be surrounded by a bunch of men in gray suits and navy blue suits. So she knew that the color would pop in all the newsreels, which it does.
And then the fact, though, after her husband is shot and killed right next to her in that motorcade, and she makes this choice as she is covered in that blood to hop that plane back to Washington, she knew she'd be photographed. Why not wash it, do you think?
Well, I mean, it was traumatic, as you said. Her husband, you know, was killed right next to her in the back of a limousine. It was traumatic, and she just, she said, let the people see what they did. So, and in fact, she kept that suit on. You know, JFK, the body was brought back to Washington. They had an autopsy. I think they finally got back to the White House with his body at about 4 o'clock in the morning the next day. Mm-hmm. And then she finally, you know.
To hear, here is this graceful, seemingly perfect First Lady, and here she is crawling in that car after her husband has been shot in this beautiful dress. I talked to one of the surviving eyewitnesses as far as what she saw when it came to the First Lady. This is what she just told me.
He did indeed look up and wave and smile, and my heart just, you know, leapt for joy. I was floating in air. And then he turned the corner and his head exploded. Then Mrs. Kennedy came out of the back seat and crawled onto the trunk. And you knew if the most sophisticated woman in the world was gonna jump out of the back seat in a skirt, that something horrible had happened. She characterized the whole tragedy, actually.
Do you agree with that, Pam? I mean, put what she did in perspective for us.
Well, I mean, she was in shock. As I said, her husband was inexplicably killed right next to where his head exploded, not to get too blunt, and that she was crawling over the back of the limousine to try to get, you know, to get pieces of his head that was on the trunk. And then, of course, Clint Hill leapt on the back of the car to try to get her in the car so they could safely race to the hospital. It was terrible. Right. It was a great tragedy.
Right. And then not too long after, you have the funeral. So she goes from this pink suit to, you know, wearing black. She has that veil. And she was 34 at the time. She was 31 when she became First Lady, 34 when her husband was assassinated. And just if you can, Pam, as we look at these archival pictures, bring me back to that time, her posture, her privacy, her legacy.
Well, I think she was very conscious always that she was the wife of the President of the United States, and she was representing this country. And she had a tremendous fear that JFK would be forgotten after he was killed, which we can't believe now, 50 years later. And she wanted a state funeral, and when she came back on the plane, she already was calling the White House, and she said, you know, go to the library and see everything you can about Lincoln's funeral. So she was going to mimic JFK's funeral, the public ceremony, the heartbreak, the grief, on Lincoln, who was obviously also assassinated.
Pam Keogh, your book is Jackie Style. Pam, thank you so much for your perspective here on the First Lady. And America changed nearly 50 years ago, forever. And now CNN puts you on the ground in Dallas, Texas. Watch the assassination of JFK. It airs tomorrow night at 9 o'clock Eastern Time and Pacific right here on CNN.